I am from Sanskrit Nyaya tradition. Therefore, there should be some scope for giving the explanation on the same topic from the Nyaya point of view. Just I will take 1 minute. Jnana is momentary. It's a property, momentary property of the self. It takes place in the self for a moment. Therefore, there is no concept of eternal jnana, nothing. See, as professor explained, knowledge is also a bondage. It is bandha. Therefore, you should get out of it. So in the moksha, according to Nyayikas, no knowledge also. Because knowledge is product of the function of our own manas and other indriyas. Once you get rid of this body, get out of this body, no bondage, no knowledge too. Even no sukha too. So you should aspire for such a state where no knowledge, no sukha, and just be yourself. I think this is very fantastic. In this level, consciousness is just being abode of knowledge. It is not the knowledge itself. So just coming out of this, because this sort of position is not acceptable to many. Because one reason, varam vrindavane ramme shigala, shigalattam vrunomyaham. Natu vaisheshikim muktim. This vaisheshika mukti is very horrible. No one would aspire for it. Because no knowledge, no bliss, nothing, just be yourself. What is this? Therefore, I take some other job. I really acknowledge the invitation of India Foundation and Nalanda University. Today, the world is passing through really tough time. Nature is disturbed. And there is a global temperature is increased and floods and no water on the other side. Actually, we should look at it. And the whole universe, I think it is soon going to be very unfit for any life. So in this context, we should bring these new categories into our deliberations. So India, for several yugas, I deliberately use word yuga, not years. We are not, because concept of time in India is not line, it is chakra. We are in this chakra. Therefore, due to certain terms pervading in the language, now these terms are disappearing and that category is also disappearing. Once these categories disappear, the whole conversation becomes very empty for us. And we are discussing using the terms like truth, consciousness. I don't know what is consciousness. I don't know what is truth. No. Now, I'm not hating English, but I am finding problem with the translation. So because my terms are satya, jnana and ananta. These terms, we are comfortable with it. So therefore, we are all Indians or non-Indians too, will be very comfortable with these terms, because these terms are to be understood by definition, not by translation. So with this background, today through this Dhamma Dharma conference, we should really try to revive these categories into Indian conversation. So these categories, we normally in our general conversation, we have karma, we have punarjanma, we have jiva, to some extent brahma. But we don't know this. Satya is used in very general context. But what is satya in the context of dharma, jnana and Nirvana, these are the terms, these are the categories which make huge difference in our worldview. I'm using worldview. The problem is not due to the problem in the nature. Problem is due to the change in our worldview. If we change our worldview, then nature behaves differently. So therefore, this is called drishti srishtivada. If I change my drishti, srishti changes. So if at all I want to change to happen in the nature, I should change my drishti. So if I change my drishti, naturally srishti will change. So with this background, so we have only one excess. Excess is walk. So my request to all philosophers assembled here, let us start using our own terms, our own categories. Those categories will definitely make huge changes in our drishti, in our conversation. So I just take four dimensions that are, this is not the time for elaborate the things, but I want to get your attention to these four terms, dimensions that are mentioned in Aitreya Upanishad. Sanjnana, four terms he uses, Sanjnana, Ajnana, Vijnana and Prajnana. Shankara says, there are many other terms which belong to the psychology, but these four terms are very important terms which we are missing in our conversation. Sanjnana is awareness, self-awareness, sanya, na pretya sanjnasti. If we die, we don't have sanya. Sanya means awareness, chetana, what we call. And ajnana, ajnana is, you know term ajna. Ajna is give instructions, control, authority. There is something which is ajna in our mind. This is called ajna, through which we govern our entire kosha, annamaya kosha, pranamaya kosha, manomaya kosha, vijnana kosha, are governed by this ajnana. So therefore, it is the ajnana, it is ajnana. A is a samanta jnanam, so ajnanam. So this gives us, it is me and it is mine, and I have ownership, I can control this. This sort of jnana is ajnana. This is next level. The third level is vijnana. Vijnana is, vijnana deals with the bhuta vastu, surroundings. Entire nature is the subject matter of vijnana. And the prajnana. Of course, prajnana has all these manifestation in the form of sanjnana, ajnana, vijnana, but prajnana is supreme knowledge which is about everything. It is sarvajnatva. So just I am bringing these concepts. So today, world is becoming sanjnana kendrita. I mean, my worldview has become sanjnana kendrita because it is only me. And rest of the whole world is for me. See, now conflict arises. If I exist and the entire world exists for me, that means I can enjoy this. So when I want to enjoy this, obstacles come and there's a fight, there's a conflict, because each human being or each individual, even the nature, wants its own existence. Then when I'm questioning, it's crossing my own limits and entering into the sphere of others' existence, naturally question arises. So these conflicts are huge in number now. Therefore, the mankind and nature have developed conflict because of this tendency, prajnana kendrita drishti. So we should move towards prajnana kendrita drishti. When I say myself, when I tell myself, I am part of this prajnana. So prajnana exists everywhere. This mic also, I cannot abuse this mic. May I abuse it? I should not abuse this mic because this has limited power. And really, I should respect it. Therefore, this prajnana kendra drishti will change our view about the world, and that changes the entire system. So therefore, without elaborating much, so satyam, jnanam, anantam. So actually today morning I was discussing with Professor Mishra, I did not find this anywhere, nowhere in the Upanishad this, but I'm glad he has found it. Let him explain later. That's that secret, that secrecy is required. And now I conclude with this, that yo vai bhuma tat sukham nalpe sukhamasti. The term jnana is placed between satya and ananta. Satya is the base, jnana towards anantatva. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.